13 years after Moya Doherty came up with the idea for Riverdance, that phenomenon just rolls on and on. It's been a spectacular hit worldwide, and recently Moya brought Riverdance back to her home county of Donegal, where the critics had nothing but good things to say.
Ladies and gentlemen, Riverdance.
I think it was the element, firstly, of surprise, that people did not expect that sort of fusion of traditional Irish dance stripped down into quite a modern way and presented it with a Broadway chorus line. And I think that whole energy and heartbeat of 26 or 28 people rhythmically in sync, pounding this extraordinary music that Bill Whelan wrote, the rhythms of that music, I think it was just shocking and exhilarating and breathtaking. And I think it happened at a time in our social and political and economic development where all things were beginning to change and we were beginning to look at ourselves in a different way. So I think it was just luck.
But it really was more than just luck. A combination of creativity and talent brought Irish dancing to a new level. The 7-minute Eurovision interval act grew to a full-scale production, showcasing Irish music and dance in a style never seen before. Bill Whelan composed a stunning score, and the original principal dancers, Michael Flatley and Jean Butler, made Irish dancing vibrant and sensuous. But even with all these exciting elements, transforming Riverdance into a stage show was a big risk for the woman behind it. But Moya Doherty and her husband, John McColgan, had such a belief in Riverdance that they remortgaged their home to make it a reality.
It was a risk because it was a lot of money in those days. It was £1.3 million, Irish pounds, to mount it in the Point Theatre, and we were only going to present it for 21 days. But once the tickets went on sale and they were launched on the Late Late Show that December for the following April, they were almost sold out straight away. So actually, what we had to do is, the business side of it was no longer a worry. We then knew we could pay back those we'd borrowed money from or those who had invested, and that it wasn't going to be a financial disaster for anybody, and we could concentrate on delivering the creative. It took off with Michael Flatley and Jean Butler at the helm, and they were extraordinary. The Irish people just took to them as these Irish Americans who brought a new athleticism to Irish dance. As I say, the wonderful music of Bill Whelan, the kind of creative energy of everybody who worked on it, the talent of the young Irish dancers whose parents had been bringing them to Irish dance lessons from the time they were four. They were suddenly professional Irish dancers, and it just took off.
Almost 20 million people worldwide have now seen Riverdance in 32 countries across 4 continents. There are now 3 companies called Boyne, Carib and Foyle on tour in Europe and the US. And one of those, Foyle, began the current Irish run of Riverdance with a very special engagement in Letterkenny in Donegal, home county of the originator of Riverdance, Moya Doherty. It was a huge undertaking. A big enough venue had to be found, first of all, to accommodate the cast and crew of 80 and all the paraphernalia that goes with them. But the brand new sports complex in Letterkenny fit the bill exactly, seating over 1,500 people per show.
I met Moya during the Mary from Dunloe Festival a few years ago, and I asked about Riverdance, and she expressed a wish that Riverdance would come home to Donegal. And that's how it happened, and then we met again in 05, and all during 06 we put the whole thing together.
That's great. Riverdance is all about Moya, and we're just delighted to be able to bring it here, and we're only able to do it because of this venue.
What do you think of the venue?
It's fantastic. It's absolutely fantastic. I mean, I've seen it now several times from an early building site through to a completed building, and what's really impressive is the quality of the design and the quality of the finish. It's really excellent.
Well, what exactly are the logistics involved in bringing a show of this scale to someplace like Letterkenny?
We're here in 5 40-foot trucks, which is, you know, a fair amount of equipment. We have to bring in a lot of metal trussing and black drapes and a lot of additional lighting and just the equipment to turn it from a sports hall into a theatre before we then put in our show as well on top of that.
A special feature of the Letterkenny shows was the number of Donegal dancers performing, among them the three McNeillis sisters from Dunloe and the lead male dancer, Michael Pat Gallagher.
It's a very proud moment for me to be able to just show the local people what it's all been about, you know, because it's actually my first time dancing Riverdance in Ireland, and not even at home here in Donegal. So I know there's great excitement in the area and around, you know, the towns and villages of County Donegal. So.
I was the first to join because I'm the eldest. I joined in 1998, so quite a while ago. And from then, my sisters came on tour after that, a year or two after that. So it's been a fabulous run. I joined when I was 17, that's about 6 years ago. And I joined the Riverdance Flying Squad because I was in college at the time. So I did some part-time Riverdance during that 4 years. And then I went on tour after that when I was finished college.
What's the Riverdance Flying Squad?
We do promotional or corporate events all over the world. You might go away for a weekend or a week here and there anytime. So it's a great opportunity to have a life at home and also do Riverdance.
Is it very special to come back to Donegal and perform here? I'm sure all your family will be here.
It will be very emotional. I do think the first few moments will be quite choked up, and it's very nervous also, but we're really looking forward to it. It's an unbelievable experience.
When you start first and when you join first, you know, it is tough. You know, there's 2 months of rehearsals before you even get on stage with the show. But then once you're integrated into the show and, you know, number after number, you get the routine down, and, you know, it kind of comes naturally enough after a while. And then, you know, the audience helps such a lot as well. Just the reaction of the audience really gets the adrenaline pumping. So it expels any nerves you might have. I have to say that in Riverdance we're treated very well. We travel with a massage therapist and physiotherapist, so that really helps a lot to really work out the aches and pains that, you know, are inevitable after, you know, touring for 6 months at a time.
It must be like a big family now because you're on the road so often together.
It is, you know, and there's so many different, you know, companies and branches, and, you know, here in Letterkenny now there's dancers I haven't seen for a couple of years that are back in the show. So there's a great sense of camaraderie and just a family feel. So. Everyone's looking out for each other.
There have been numerous weddings among the Riverdance teams through the years, and the latest is the lead female dancer in the Letterkenny shows. She married a musician in the company, and they were just back from honeymoon in time for the tour.
It takes its toll, you know, and living out of a suitcase is quite hard, but it's just getting on stage makes it all worthwhile. And, you know, it's the audience feedback as well, which is just great, and it's just fantastic to get that from them, and just makes it all so worthwhile. But, you know, touring is hard, and it is, you know, but it, dancing is our life. And, I mean, we've trained, you know, as hard as any Olympic athlete for 20 years, you know, dancing. And there's kids dancing there up at the World Championships, and they train so hard, and it makes it worthwhile to come here and to be able to dance on a world stage, and to dance professionally is just something else. It's just great.
Gave Irish dancers an opportunity to do something, to make a living out of something that they never believed they could make their living out of. And what better, you know, what better way to spend 10 years of your life than touring the world, dancing and seeing wonderful cities, and, you know, your job, basically at the end of your job, people stand up and shout and scream and ask for more. I mean, not a lot of people can say that they have that level of job satisfaction. I've heard the show more than most people, and still when I sit in the audience, having not seen it for a while, there's something quite special, something very, very magical about it, and that little tingle. And I know I'm very, very heavily associated with it, but that's enough to put you off it. You might have heard enough of it or seen it enough times. There's something about it, and no matter where you go, the universal themes and whatever that kind of like heartbeat or that rhythm, the fantastic music, how all those elements come together, it's kind of flawless from the point of view of how the show is structured. And anybody who hasn't seen it, but, you know, a lot of people, they criticise saying maybe it's old hat, it was very early 90s. A lot of those people may not have seen it or haven't seen it for a while. And it has held the standard, and that is the one thing. And that's what's great about the Riverdance Company and Moya Doherty, Julian Erskine, John McColgan. They have somebody like me there to make sure that the standards remain high, that that never dips.
The new sports complex was literally finished just on time for the arrival of Riverdance in Donegal. And after opening nights in places like Broadway and Beijing, Moya Doherty was really looking forward to the gala opening night in Letterkenny.
Oh, I think it'll be very emotional. Very emotional for me, I suppose, because both my parents have passed away. So I think that it would have been wonderful to have had them there, particularly my mother, who just died recently. So I think that element of it is going to be both incredibly joyous and incredibly sad.
But that sadness was greatly lifted by the fantastic response to Riverdance in Letterkenny. And to add something extra special on opening night, a cheque for €92,500, the profits from all the shows and a matching sum from Moya, was donated to Letterkenny General Hospital.
The profits from this event are going to the local hospital to buy a cancer scanning machine. And that just makes it really worthwhile for all of us to be able to leave a mark behind us.
The tickets sold at approximately 1,000 an hour. Okay, so but we'll release two and then we'll release another three. We could never catch up with ourselves. And in discussions with the company, of course, we were saying it's the one problem we never had, is selling tickets. Hand on heart, I could honestly say we could do another four shows. We would have about another 5,000 people, which, fingers crossed, if it all goes well, we may have Riverdance back in Donegal next year, hopefully.
Well, that's Riverdance, 13 years on, and my goodness, it still has that sparkle.